Using a cell phone while driving in any form should be banned. That was the unanimous recommendation today of the National Transportation Safety Board. It said the ban should apply both to hands-free and handheld phones and other portable devices. That would exceed restrictions already imposed in many states. We get more from Deborah Hersman, head of the NTSB. Ms. Hersman, thanks for being with us. 35 states already have on the books some sort of ban against texting while driving. Why do your recommendations to ban all portable electronic devices go further than that?
Unfortunately, in 10 years of investigations, we've seen that distractions cause accidents that result in fatalities, lost lives, and injuries. We've seen this in all modes of transportation, but in particular on our nation's highways.
If the purpose is to decrease the amount of distracted driving, couldn't the case be made that when I change music stations on my car radio, when I eat, when I talk to another passenger, I'm equally as distracted?
Well, for sure, there are a lot of distractions that are facing today's drivers. But one of the things that we know is that all distractions are not equal. It's the distractions that really require cognitive attention. It requires you to split your tasks, and human beings are really just not very good at that. What you do is you'd end up diverting attention away from the primary task at hand, and that's driving. It's different when you have a passenger in the car with you. They can help you. They are aware of the traffic situation. They're aware when things get complicated. They don't expect you to respond when you get into a tight situation. But the person on the other end of the line really is not helpful when it comes to reacting and adapting to the environment.
Now, the NTSB has sort of recommendation authority, but it doesn't have any enforcement authority. How, if states were to take your ban, would they possibly enforce something like this?
Well, as you mentioned, there are 35 states that already have texting bans, and so law enforcement authorities are actually faced with many difficult tasks when it comes to enforcing laws, detecting impaired drivers, whether they're on drugs or whether they've been consuming alcohol, detecting drivers who are performing erratically. It's the things that you see when you're out on the road and you know that somebody's texting or they're talking on the phone and they're distracted. They're not maintaining speed. They're not maintaining their lane. They are distracted. Their driving is erratic or it's not consistent. Unfortunately, we see this too often. It doesn't take long to have a catastrophic event or an accident. As we saw in our investigation today that the board reported on, there was a driver who was sending and receiving 11 texts in the 11 minutes before the accident. He was in a work zone, and immediately traffic came to a stop. He was involved in a fatal accident. No call, no text, no post is worth a human life.
All right, Deborah Hersman, head of the NTSB, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you for having me.